I want to share something with you before I'm going to get into my message today. And I want to go back 55 years in time. And I'm going to talk about the situation we had in Vietnam during the war from about 1963 up to 1975. During the tragedy at the time of the Vietnam War was simply this, that you had a war with no really front lines. So the American military established fire bases, and they would simply go into hilltops, and they would there would be no roads up to them, and they would airlift in bulldozers and equipment, flatten off the top, and then they would prepare bunkers and so on. They would fly in their big artillery pieces. And it was fortified, and usually on a fire base like that, they had maybe up to 1,500 American soldiers, most of them Marines or U.S. Army. The strategy now was simply this, that they wanted to have fire bases all over South Vietnam. And as they encountered the enemy, first the VC, the Viet Cong, later on the North Vietnamese, they simply would use these fire bases to lay down a withering fire on the enemy, and they could cover a large territory. The communists did not like that, and they realized that these fire bases was very vital to take them out because they did a lot of damage to the communist side. So many times, these fire bases came under a tremendous attack where they would send in thousands of Vietnamese, and they would simply disregard their lives. They would get up to the raised wires, and they would get stuck in there, and then they would get enough people on the wires that they could climb over them and get inside the base. And it was hand-to-hand combat, and hundreds and hundreds of American soldiers lost their lives. So I want you to have that picture in your mind. This ministry is a fire base. We are located here in the Sacramento area, and we have weapons, spiritual weapons, that we are using around the world, not just locally, but in many different places. The enemy is not happy with that. And we are under severe attack right now. We pray for a lot of people. This is a time when we need prayer from you. Usually when my wife and I take a time off to go and seek the Lord and rest, when we come back, we usually have difficulties. And this time was no exception. And so we are facing a number of issues that we need prayer for. And there were three things that I had to deal with this week. And instead of being able to move on doing things that God had told me to do, I've basically been in damage control this week. And it's been a rough week. The first thing that we need help for is simply this. When a fire base in Vietnam was attacked, they called in air support, and they got support from the Air Force, they got helicopter gunships, and they got reinforcement. And they also got ammo drops because they ran out of ammunition, food drops, and so on. And I'm asking today that we need some help. We need prayer. But we also need some ammunition drops, we need some food supplies, and we need help in general. Let me talk to you about our first problem, water. Back in 1990, God told my wife and me to relocate outside Sacramento, and we are about 40 miles north of Sacramento in the countryside, and this is not, we don't have city water. We are sitting on a well. Well, this week I was told that we have problems with the water. And the neighbor informed us yesterday, or 2 days ago, that that well has dried, which is only about 40 feet from our well. And we noticed yesterday that the water pressure was going down. If we do not have water, we cannot be on this property. Water is vital. And I had not planned to spend money on fixing the water supply. We have problems. We need to replace our equipment that we are doing webcasting with. And suddenly, the enemy simply honed in on this and gave us this problem. How can this be solved? Well, we need to drill a new well. That's going to cost money. And I'm asking some of you are giving generously. But I'm going to ask if some of you simply say this, well, we have a little bit extra here, we have this there, and so on. If you can give a lump sum and simply say, if you want to make sure that they have water at the fire base so that we can function. So I really appreciate that. We need prayer. We're going to have to take out permits. County will not give us problems. And that we will have this resolved quickly. So that's my number one problem that I had to face this week. The second thing we had to face was a financial problem. Usually when I go away and I'm not preaching, the income drops. Here's where we are right now. There was enough money that we could pay current bills, current salaries, but we have not paid our Social Security taxes. And we need to do that. We also need to replace equipment. And we need to start setting aside money for that. So I want you to pray for the financial situation, that God will move upon people. There are people that are a bit blessed. You might be an older person, and when I say older, anything over 30 years of age. And you might have simply says, well, you know, I have set aside some money for mission work or whatever it is. Well, consider us here in California. We need your help. The third thing was a thing that really hit me below the belt. And it was very, very hard to take. One of our members here on the team has developed a sickness that I do not want to describe, that the person doesn't want to talk about it. But it was a devastating news when I heard that, because sickness is something that the enemy is attacking us with. And this is not a cold, or this is not a headache, but this is a major disease, a sickness that might lead to a departure to heaven, premature. And I'm on prayer for that. Myself, God has kept me in good health, but we have been struggling. I have problem about a month ago. We prayed for that. God healed me from that. My wife continues to need to have a healing. And the other people in the ministry that are struggling with different diseases and different attacks on the body. So if you can understand where we're at, we're trying to minister hard, trying to reach out, trying to do all these different things. At the same time, we got all these physical problems that are weighing down. And you know, if you love somebody and you find out they have a disease that is eventually fatal, it does something to you. It's not something you walk away from and says, well, oh, well, you know, we're all going to die sometime, one or the other, so what's the difference? It makes something to you. And it has affected me hard this week. And so we need prayer for that. Water, financial, and for God to heal. Now, I know you know this, that people will say, well, You have deliverance. You pray for the sick. What's wrong with you? Why don't you pray for your own people? Can't they get well? We do. But here's the situation. If you read the book of Job, it took a while before God intervened and pulled Satan off the back of Job. Sometimes you get an instant healing. Sometimes you get a delayed healing, and sometimes you get a very delayed healing. We do not know when, how, but we do know that we have a God that loves us. It takes prayer. Now, if you go back to the book of Acts, after Jesus had been crucified, Judas went and hung himself before Jesus was crucified. And yet the 11 apostles left. And you would think that, you know, God would simply protect them. But it was only maybe 6 to 7 months that James, the brother of John, was arrested, beheaded. He never had a chance to do his apostolic work. He was wiped out, taken out. Peter was next. The church started praying hard. Peter was saved. But all the apostles encountered heartaches, financial problems, personal problems, church problems. And the only one that died of old age was the Apostle John. All the others were executed. And as we go in history, you will find out that any time that you begin to do something in the kingdom of God, there's going to be retribution, attacks from the devil. It comes for the territory. We push back. We don't lay down. We use supplements. We use natural food. We use what we can with our hands. And then we soak it in prayer. And this is where we are right now. So we need prayer for this particular person that I mentioned about this week. I also need prayer for myself, for my wife. And we got several other people, I'm not going to mention them here today on the webcast, that are fighting. Matter of fact, I think you only have maybe one person or two persons in the ministry, either staff or a part of the church here, that is not struggling and fighting some kind of a physical attack of sickness or that nature. So we need prayer. So I appreciate that. I wanted to share that with you. I have confidence in God. And instead of laying down, we're just going to shoot harder and do more damage to Satan's kingdom. And with your help and prayer, financial support, we are going to do just that. So I want to thank you for responding. And we're going to keep going. Praise the Lord.